My family moved into this neighborhood in 1925, and to me it was a heaven, a little close-knit, safe, comfortable neighborhood.
When Wendel told me that he was interested in going out to Newtonville and looking at some of the old homesteads and some of the sites where their historic significance in New Jersey and the lives of rural Black Americans, I was really excited about it.
These are places that are almost artifacts of a bygone era in which Black people voluntarily sought to separate from whites in an effort to be by themselves and to be safe and sound.
May the spirit and wisdom of small Black towns stir your soul.
Ooh, awesome.
One of the things that kept me going is the degree to which these communities really do have a connection to the stories that I heard growing up. They would go in the summertime when they were off from school and visit their grandparents on the farm. And that farm was purchased as the result of my great-grandfather's coming out of the Civil War and the pay that the soldiers received during the Civil War. You got a lump sum at the end. You didn't get, you know, paid while you were serving. So you got muster out pay. And when you got your muster out pay, people invested that in the opportunity to buy land, to build a home, to start communities.
South Jersey's Black population derives from two historic events, the Underground Railroad. And the second reason why South Jersey figures prominently in the Black town and settlement movement has to do with some enterprising Black people who move into South Jersey and try to replicate in South Jersey the Black town movement which was found in the South and in the Southwest.
George H. White, who was actually the last African-American congressman to serve at the end of the post-Reconstruction era, founded a real estate company that helped sell property there and helped in what would be sort of thought of as community building.
These little small towns are rapidly turning over. And I'm not opposed to integration. You know, that's evolution. But at least we ought to capture what they were before they all are dissolved or turned over or merged with the larger communities and all.
It started as an artist's journal, is the way he likes to describe it, in Whitesboro in 1989. And it has since grown to encompass at least 12 communities throughout southern New Jersey that share a sort of common heritage in this way. Wendel is in a tradition of Dorothea Lange, of Jacob Riis, these sorts of artists who have helped us focus in on aspects of our community, in many ways, things that are very ordinary, and help to elevate them.
I'm actually out photographing things just as they are, what I see very contemporary, the contemporary world. And the problem that I have was how do I try to infuse into that work the stories and the information and the history that led up to what I see today. And that's what led me to incorporating text.
I worked on a farm, and if they purchased a piece of land, they would just build a basement, and they would actually live underground until the next year when they had made enough money to put the top on the house. So that's why it's called the dugout house.
Jenny Morris was a undertaker or funeral director in Philadelphia and wanted to purchase property, a summer home, and was, you know, successful enough and wanted to purchase a summer home. And I think it was in Ocean City. And because of racial boundaries, you know, she wasn't successful. And so she discovered this property where she decided to form her own community. And in a community called Small Gloucester, there's still a church there that's active and a cemetery connected to that church. And about a year and a half ago, there was a group of historical interpreters that do the United States Colored Troops, which served during the Civil War, that came to the community to help rededicate the cemetery. And so the photograph of Frederick Minas is a photograph that I took in the basement of the church after the ceremony. while the experience of slavery went on for centuries, there's also a centuries-long tradition of self-sufficiency and communities and intellectual vitality and civic engagement.
He really brought the place to life and captured the essence of what makes a small town special.